Hello Facebook, welcome to Midday Mastery with me, Steve Woody from Online Mastery, and today is all about what system should I use? So I talked yesterday in the video when I was talking about landing pages, and I said that today I was going to talk about systems and what systems you should be using and specifically how you should be using them. So I'm going to spend the next 20 to 30 minutes going through this. If you've got any questions at all about the systems you're currently using, the systems you think you should be using, if you've got some questions about what industry you're in and what are the right systems to use, post a question. I will answer it live. This is a Q&A session. I'm going to spend the next 20 to 30 minutes talking to basically entrepreneurs, business owners, any of you. If you have a product or a service that you are trying to sell or promote or get out there, then you need to have some systems in place. So one of the things that I talk about often with people is that my speciality and what I do is two things. It really boils down to, I have two like key areas that I focus on. One is the customer journey. So I always say, when someone says, I need a website, I say, your website is not about you. Your website is about the customer. It's about the people who are going to come to your website and how they interact with you. So that's the first thing that you need to know, is who's going to come to your website. The second thing is, what systems do you have in place to help you throughout the journey? So there are things that you can use to give you more time, to give you more freedom as an individual. There's things you can use as a business to leverage and scale. There's ways that you can get yourself out there. There's a lot of things that you can do. And so what I want to talk about now is kind of like a shopping list, if you like, because here's the reality. We all use Facebook, we're all on Facebook, and often when we have a question, we'll either ask Google or we'll ask Facebook. It's just the way we go. A lot of people tend to prefer to ask Facebook because you get an interaction with people that you know, you like, you trust. And when they give you an opinion, you tend to take that opinion. Now, this can be good because you can learn some amazing new things, but it can also be really bad. And the reason it can be really bad is because people that are giving you their opinions, they mean well, but they don't necessarily understand what it is that you need. And the best question, I'm going to talk about this tomorrow. Tomorrow's video is all about hosting, and I'm going to talk to you about different hosting solutions. And one of the worst questions that people ask is, what host should I use for my website? People will tell you what host they're using. People will tell you what host they recommend. Doesn't necessarily mean it's the right host for you. And it's the same with your systems. Hey, Raquel. Hey, Robert. How you doing, by the way? Nice to see you. If you've got any questions, as I say, do comment below. So what I really want to cover right now are the systems. So let's take it back to the beginning. Let's go to the very start here. And let's talk about when you say, the first question that most people say is, I need a website. Something that people always say is, oh, I need a website. Now, if you go to a WordPress developer and you say, I want a website, they'll say you should use WordPress. If you go to a Drupal developer, which is a different platform, and tell them you need a website, they'll tell you to build it on Drupal. If you go to someone who custom builds websites, they'll tell you it should be custom built and bespoke. And so if you go to someone who uses ClickFunnels, they'll tell you that you should use ClickFunnels. And people are going to tell you what they use and what they recommend. But it doesn't necessarily mean it's what's right for you. So the reason that I like to think that I'm a little bit different is because I learned Joomla, I learned Drupal, I learned how to custom build websites, I learned WordPress, I learned ClickFunnels, I learned Kajabi, I learned Lead Pages. I've learned everything that's out there that's worth knowing. Everything that's out there, including the new systems that are coming out, like Heroic, when you look at Rainmaker platform, when you look at all the things, when you look at Ghost that was going to replace WordPress, there's so many systems out there, so many systems. And so I went and I learned all the different systems and I looked at all the different systems. And what I realized is that I never used to like WordPress. I never used to like it. And when anyone that used it, I go, shouldn't use WordPress. It was just my bullshit internal story that I had going on in my head that it wasn't valuable and that you should work hard and work really hard at building websites. The reality is I've learned since then, and I'm, you know, man enough to admit it, that I made a mistake. It's not about working hard, it's about working smart. And if you can work smart, you're going to leverage your time and you're going to leverage your resources better. That's important. So I moved over to WordPress, and the reason I moved over to WordPress is because 30% of the internet uses WordPress. You're talking about almost 80 million websites use WordPress. Now, I know there's Wix and Squarespace and Weebly, and there's all of these other examples of systems that are out there, but 80 million websites. There's a reason for that. And the reason for it, and this is what's really important and why I want to get this point across, is I was told, and this is really, this hit home for me, this was the pivot for me, using a well-built WordPress theme is the equivalent of 10,000 hours of hard code. So if you want to build a website from scratch and you want to use a well-built WordPress theme, a professional theme, the difference is about 10,000 hours in coding. Now, whether that's true or not, I don't know, but it definitely hit home for me. So when I build websites, specifically when I build websites for myself or for clients, or I have done in the past, I will use WordPress. Now, that's not to say that WordPress is the answer and it is the only thing that you should use, but there are some benefits to using it. There are some drawbacks as well, and I'm going to talk about these quickly now, and then I'm going to go into more detail and we're going to cover some more things. So if you've got any questions, do let me know, I will answer them. But WordPress, now, this is where it gets a little bit confusing with WordPress, because WordPress has two versions. There's WordPress.com and there's WordPress.org. Now, WordPress.com is just as bad as using Squarespace, as using Weebly, as using all of these Wix and all of these other channels. And let me just give you some context here. Using Squarespace, Wix and Weebly is not a bad thing. Okay, I wanna just put that out there. It's not a bad thing. Depending on where you are, depending on what is right for you, getting out there and getting started and getting online is more important than finding the perfect system. Getting out there and getting started and getting online is more important than searching for the perfect system. The reason I say that is I would much rather that you have a shitty website on Squarespace than have no website at all. Because if you have a website, you can improve it, you can build, you can learn, you can get yourself out there. And as I can tell you, I can attest to this, there's a gentleman called Simon Coulson. Many of you might know him. He runs the online internet business school. He would build WordPress websites. And this was back in the day before I liked WordPress. And I was custom building HTML websites. And my coding was meticulous. I was so, like, my code was perfect. My design was shit. They look crap. But the code, the structure, the way they were built, oh, it was beautiful. I spent so much time, like, structuring out all of the site, making up sort of markup was perfect. Absolutely perfect. What I realized is I was broke and I had no money. And I was spending so long on clients that didn't appreciate, because no one gives a shit about the code of a website. When's the last time you looked at the view source of your website, if you're not a developer, and looked at the sort of code that's been output? No one cares. All you care about is that it's responsive, it works well, and people buy shit. That's all people want to know from a business perspective. So it's really about the coding side of it. Simon didn't really know or care about that side of it. He just wanted to know that the websites worked and he was churning out lots of websites. There was a reason I was skint and he was earning multi-millions. He was earning millions and millions and millions of pounds through his services because he was putting stuff out there. He was creating. I was also creating, but on a very different scale. So using a system like Squarespace or Weebly or Wix to hone, to test your market, to hone your message, to get your systems right, to do whatever you need to do, I'm not saying that's a bad idea. What I'm saying is that in the long term, if you want a sustainable online business, they are not going to help you. And the reason they're not going to help you is because you're not in your own playground. You don't own this. You're renting it. You don't own your website. If you're on Squarespace, that is not your website. You do not own your website on Squarespace. You are renting a website from them. And because you're renting a website from them, they can cancel the lease at any time. There goes your website. There goes your online business. You have no control. Oh, you think you have control. You have a perceived control. But they can change the rules. They can change the game at any time. Any time. And that is why it is important to understand that when you use WordPress, and not .com, because .com is exactly the same, but when you use WordPress.org, you actually download this. You download it, you have to host it on your own server, and that means that you own it. It is open source. It uses what is called a GPL license, which is a general purpose license or a public license. I can't actually remember what it stands for, but the point I'm trying to make is that you own it. It is open source code, and it means that you can edit, tweak, change, play about with. You can do whatever you want to that code. Some of the best systems out there at the moment are open source. If you have an open source system, it means that you can take, tweak, contribute towards because there's a whole community of volunteers who work for WordPress, who update, who evolve, who change the system to make it better. That's why it's constantly updating and constantly evolving, because there's so many amazing people in the world working on it. When you use a WordPress website, you're not just, it's not just you. You have 10,000 developers behind you who are also doing things. So whenever you need something, chances are it's already been made. There's already a plugin or an extension or something that you can use. That's why it's so successful. If you're using one of these systems, you're limited to their hardware. You're limited to their software. You will always be putting a square peg in a round hole. And I want you to understand that, because here, yes, this is more complicated to use. Yes, the onboarding process isn't as slick. Yes, there's definitely some things that you need to go through in terms of a learning curve, but the outcome here is going to be so much better for you, because you are going to be in control, because you are going to have the systems that you need for your business, not what everyone else recommends. Yes, of course, start off on Squarespace, start off on ClickFunnels. You know, start off on whatever you need. If you need a website or you need an online presence to get out there, this is my recommendation. This is what I would recommend. Get yourself a ClickFunnels account. Go to clickfunnels.uk. Disclaimer, that is absolutely my domain. I own it. And yes, I will get commission if you end up purchasing ClickFunnels. But do you know what? I use it. Russell Brunson's a great guy. We talk a lot. And I will testify for him, because when we was in San Diego and I had a chat with Russell Brunson, he gave me a nugget. It was such a small little nugget. It was a quick conversation, and to him it was just like, he just said something, but it triggered in me that caused me to rewrite my entire book, because I was missing a chapter and he gave me the nugget that allowed me to write chapter 2 of my book. And subsequently, as a result of that, the remaining chapters all had to change. So I love him and I hate him. I love him because now my book is, you know, it's an international bestseller. I sell thousands of copies and people love it. I love it for that reason. I hate him because I had to rewrite my whole bloody book because of him. But he was right in what he was saying. He is the world's leading authority in sales funnels. And love him or hate him, you can't deny he's got an awesome system. ClickFunnels is great. It allows you to very, very quickly put up a mock-up website or a sales funnel or a process to test. And I'll say this, and you know, Russell says you don't need a website anymore, and I disagree, because I do think you do still need one. I think they have a shelf life. I think websites in the next 10 years are going to die out. I think app virtualization is going to take over. But for now, what we have here and what we're using, your website should always be reinvented every 2 to 3 years. Okay, technology is moving so quickly that whatever system you're using, you need to keep redefining it. And so you do not want to invest loads and loads and loads and loads of money. You don't want to put 20, 30, 40, 50 grand into a website. Like, take for example, Business Link. UK website Business Link spent 130 million. Just take that in for a moment. No, I stand corrected, 105. 105 million on their website. 105 million pounds. £35 million a year for 3 years for a website that, guess what, doesn't even exist anymore. Doesn't even exist. After 3 years, they realised it didn't work. Yeah, we paid for that. Taxpayers also paid for NHS Choices. All right, so that does get some traction. That was still £61 million for that website. It's really important to understand that you have a lot of companies out there who are established, and yet they're like dinosaurs. So why do these startups get so much traction? Why do these solopreneurs out there who are telling you they're making 6 or 7 figures, how do they do it? It's not because they've invested all this money in these systems. They just get stuff out there quickly. They test it. They find out what works and they hone in on that. And then they make that work. And that's what you need to do. You need an agile website that just works, that does what it needs to do. And you can build out systems. You can evolve them. But there is no point building something for yourself that doesn't work. You need to know it works first. You need to find out if there's an interest, and then you need to build it out. All right, this is a conversation I had with a client last night. A client I was talking to last night spent £50,000 on education. She has so much knowledge in her head that she is absolutely paralysed by it and can't implement. And so I've had to actually force her to stop learning, just so that she can actually start implementing what she's doing. Because knowledge is fantastic. I can teach you all of this. I can tell you about all of this. If you don't go and apply it, it's not worth shit. If you don't go and apply this, it's not worth shit. And you shouldn't get overwhelmed by it. It is so easy to look at this, and I can sit here with you and go, oh, what am I going to do? Do you know what? Doesn't matter. One thing. Do one thing. Start at the beginning. Relax. Don't worry about all this. All I'm doing you is showing you a system, showing you a way. If you want my recommendation, because I can tell you all the different systems and all the different things that are out there, but here's what I know. I've tested pretty much everything. I know what works, I know what doesn't. I've sunk well over £20,000 on software. I've got all the invoices to prove it. I've spent well over £20,000 on all the different software. I own every single webinar platform that is out there, all the way from Webinar Jam to Easy Webinar to, you know, everything that's been created out there. Infusionsoft, CRM systems. I've got Infusionsoft, I've got ActiveCampaign. I was paying for them both together because I was learning them both and using them both. We've got plugins that we've created for them. I'm telling you now, every CRM system that's out there, everything from Capsule all the way through to Salesforce, I've tested everything. And there are great systems out there. But you don't need to know about everything. You can get blindsided by all the dazzling lights out there. And the reality is, you just need to start. So, as a starting point, what do I recommend? If you're a business owner or you are an entrepreneur and you are looking to sell products and services or services, then it is really, really simple. What I recommend you do, this is my recommendation. If you're starting out at your very beginning of your journey, get ClickFunnels. Very, very easy, very, very simple. Go to clickfunnels.uk, because if you're going to get it, you may as well get it through me. ClickFunnels.uk, get yourself ClickFunnels, 2-week trial, and build out a system, build out a funnel, test it, see if it works, test out the copy, test out the ads. They're like one-click buttons. Like, you can one click, you can build out that entire funnel, and you can test it, and you can make sure it works. So get that to test. Now, this is what I do. This is my recommendation. Once you've found something that works, and within 2 weeks, you can find something that works. So I'm not saying you should do this, but you can get a free account, test out the funnels, make sure it works, and then you can take that and cancel the account if you want to, so you don't pay for it. Then what I recommend you do is you set up a WordPress.org account. WordPress.org. Now, when you do that, you'll download it, or if you've got a host, because if you're hosting your website, because you will need to host it, most of them these days have one-click installs and they can set it up, or you can find people to set this up for you. There's enough virtual assistants and PAs out there. Every single person out there now who's anyone involved in business knows how to install and set up WordPress. And this is the challenge. When you look to hire a developer to work for you, most WordPress developers, doesn't exist by the way, it's a bullshit term, but people call themselves WordPress developers, they can install WordPress. WordPress comprises of two things. You have a theme, right? The theme is the look and the feel of the site. It's how it looks, feels, and functions. And then you have what are called plugins. Now, a plugin plugs in to that theme. Hey, Debbie. Nice to see you. Thanks for the little icons. They look pretty cool. Plugins, they plug into the theme. They give it additional functionality. So when you get your WordPress, this is your... It's called a CMS, content management system. All right, it means that you can have a website that does not require a developer anymore, because you don't need a developer to build all this. Like, the way technology's evolved right now, click, 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 done, done, done. That's the problem with WordPress developers, is they can install a theme and they can install some plugins. Click, 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 done. But they're calling themselves WordPress developers. Okay, so they're calling themselves a developer and you think, oh, they're a developer. So you hire them and you pay a developer rate, which, by the way, I pay my lead developer £100 an hour. So that gives you a good idea. And he is amazing, absolutely amazing. He can code PHP, HTML, CSS, JavaScript. He can do everything. And he understands WordPress. Like, if you want somebody who is a WordPress developer, ask him these questions. Ask him these questions. Do you understand the loop? Do you understand queries? And do you understand the template hierarchy? I can't spell hierarchy, but they're the three things. If somebody is an expert in WordPress, they need to understand at the absolute minimum, they need to understand those things, as well as PHP, CSS, and HTML. Okay, PHP, CSS, and HTML are coding languages. All right, the loop, the queries, and the template hierarchy, those are the things that make WordPress so powerful. That's like the engine that sits under the hood that makes it do the things it does. And when people understand that, they can do, you can do things with WordPress you can't even imagine. Like the stuff you can do when you understand this, it's phenomenal. So, a WordPress developer needs to understand those things, not just how to install a theme and plugin. And that is why when most of the times, when you hire a developer and you say, can you just do something for me? And they go, oh, I don't know how to do it because it's more than just pressing a button. Now I need to know code and I need to understand things that I don't know because I was bullshitting you, telling you I can do something I can't. That's when they disappear. And that's when you end up going, what the fuck, where's my developer gone? Because most people, especially on Elance People Per Hour, don't ever go to Fiverr.com. If you go to Fiverr.com, just send me a message and I'll come around and slap you. Because if you're looking for a developer on Fiverr.com, good luck. That's all I can say today, is just good luck. So, back to my point. WordPress.org, it works. It's really good. You need a theme. What theme should you use? Well, funny you should mention that. Themeco. I love these guys. I love them so much they come to my wedding. Kyle, Alex, the team are phenomenal. They are amazing. They have built one of the best themes on, if you go into a theme forest. Now here's another thing I'm just gonna educate you on very, very quickly. Theme forest. Anybody who knows what theme forest is, they'll tell you that it's a place where you can get themes and plugins and, you know, it's a company called Invato. And it's an amazing repository. It has loads and loads of stuff on it. You can go to, it's made up of different components. There's Video Hive, where you can get videos. Graphic River, where you can get graphics. Audio Jungle, where you can get audio. By the way, last night I went on Audio Jungle, downloaded an audio introduction for my podcast. I hope you listened to the first episode of my podcast. I was so excited. I recorded it last night. And I love the little intro I've got. It feels really good. So, yeah, I've got my little intro beat now. I've got my little Video Hive is where I get all my intro animations. And I just code them up myself. Costs like $5, $10 and it's done. That's good because I can do that. But if you go onto Theme Forest, okay, Theme Forest. And there's also another one called Code Canyon. Now, two types of people, right? You've got a developer and you've got a business owner. Two types of people. They will have a very different experience. If you ask a business owner what they think of Theme Forest, they'll go, oh, it's amazing. Absolutely amazing. $60 and you can buy a theme. It's fantastic. You can go and you can buy a theme and you can plug it in and install it and set it up and it's great. So you talk to any business owner, they'll tell you Theme Forest is fantastic. Speak to any hardcore developer and they'll tell you it's the biggest repository of shit on the internet. Because so many people are throwing stuff up there and it's getting approved, but reality is it just doesn't last. It's not that good. Stuff gets taken down all the time. People are getting it up there just to try and make money. There's only a few people on there who are doing something because they genuinely want to make a difference. And Themeco are one of those companies. They have a theme called X. It's called the X theme. Now, anybody who knows me will know the X theme because it's the only theme I use. When I used to build websites for people, I would say, okay, let's go on Theme Forest and let's have a look. Because I used to custom build websites. Then I moved over to Twitter Bootstrap and I learned that. Then I moved to WordPress and I would custom build. In fact, on YouTube, I've got a whole documentary of teaching people how to custom build their own theme. The reality is, it's not worth it. Because if you custom build a theme, then you constantly need a developer to update it. The idea between purchasing a professional theme is that they will update it. You don't have to. If anything new comes out, if anything happens, they look after it. You don't have to worry about it. That's the big thing between using a free and a premium theme. A free theme, of course, whilst people are excited about it, they're going to update it. But I can promise you now that if people are putting a lot of effort into something and not getting paid for it, after a while, their interest will decline. And that is why this company, they do very well. You know, they've made millions through this and I don't blame them because they deserve it. One of the best themes out there. And so I had to make a decision because what I used to do was go to a client and say, we could use this theme or that theme and we could use Divi or Genesis or Avada or, you know, there's lots, we could use Optimized Press and there was all these different themes that we could use. And I had to learn all these different themes and I had to learn all these different systems. The reality is I don't do that anymore. When you come to me, you use X theme. If you don't use X theme, you don't come to me. It's as simple as that. You go somewhere else. That was the what I started to apply. And for the last 2 years, I have only used the X Team, and it does absolutely everything it needs to do. All right, if you have some custom development work that needs doing, it will slow the process down. Yes, it will. However, for a business owner, for an entrepreneur, for somebody who has products and services and who needs to get out there and create their message, then this is a very easy and simple and cost-effective, like $63 and you own it for life. Unlimited updates. There's no monthly or yearly fee. See, ClickFunnels has a monthly fee, and it's good as a starting point. And I do use ClickFunnels. I use ClickFunnels to build out my themes, to test things, to know if it works. And once I know it works, I rebuild it in X. And the reason I do that is because this is the theme and they have a plugin. And the plugin is called Cornerstone. Now, Cornerstone is really the biggest, like in terms of websites, it is the biggest advance that we have seen in the last sort of 5 to 10 years. And not just Cornerstone, it's what Cornerstone is. It is a page builder. It is a drag and drop page builder. And it is what makes things like Wix and Squarespace and Weebly so desirable. And even ClickFunnels, because you can just drag things around, drop them, see them, move them. And people love that because you can edit things on the screen. It used to be you would code something, upload it, test it, go back, code something, upload it, test it. You don't do that anymore. You edit things live on the screen and you press publish and it's done. Like we've evolved, we've changed. As a result, you don't need a developer to build a website anymore. All you need is a designer and a content writer. That's it. If you have those two things, then you can build a website. So it started with WordPress, and I'm not saying this was a beginning, but it started in terms of mass, like the public knowledge, with a plugin called Visual Composer. Now, some people will know Visual Composer. Visual Composer is a drag and drop page builder. Depends who you speak to. Speak to a business owner, they'll tell you they love it. Speak to a developer, they'll cry. I've cried. Visual Composer is a great concept, but because it's trying to do so much, it bloats out the code. It puts so much additional code, which slows down your site, which causes bugs, which causes conflicts with other plugins. There's also the other element that it's just not that friendly. Like when you look at the SEO and Google, like all of the inline page styles and everything it uses, it's throwing a big mess together. So it looks good so you can drag and drop, but behind the scenes, it's just like spaghetti. And so you end up with bugs, errors, you're constantly trying to fix your site. When I used to go into a site to try and fix it with Visual Composer, the first thing I'd do, disable Visual Composer, the site would work. But here's the problem, if you remove Visual Composer, all the site breaks. So like it doesn't look the way it did. So you're kind of trapped. If you use Visual Composer to build a page, you need Visual Composer. You remove Visual Composer, that page no longer works. So you need to understand there's other page builders out there. There's one called Beaver Builder, fantastic. It allows you to build up a page, you can use it, and then if you remove it, the page is still there. You've still got the code. Cornerstone come along, and Cornerstone basically was created because ThemeCo was sick and tired of all the bugs with Visual Composer. So they decided to create their own. And what they have now is a really, really good system between X and Cornerstone that just works. And they're just about to launch like version 5. And it's phenomenal. What they're doing and the roadmap and how it's going. I was sitting on a Skype call with the founder a couple of days ago. And we was having a chat and I can't share anything because obviously it's all very hush-hush at the moment. But they've got some insane things that are coming out this year. This year's going to be amazing for them. And I can't wait to watch it. So, in terms of recommendations, if you've got a WordPress website, I recommend using the X Theme and using Cornerstone. So, let me just go further into the different plugins now that I recommend. Because if you're using Wix or Weebly or Squarespace, like, good luck to you and everything. I'm not against you. In fact, that's where I pick up most of my work. When I do my Facebook ads, I target people with Squarespace websites who are not getting results. Because I can tell you, pretty much everyone who has a Wix, Weebly or Squarespace website, they built it, but it doesn't work. Doesn't do what they want it to do. And I'd say that's probably about 99% of people. Most of my traffic comes from targeting Wix, Squarespace, Weebly. You know, Wix gets 1.5 million hits a month. 1.5 million hits a month. It's just free business for me. That's what I've started doing now. I just target those. And I'm like, I'm not trying to convince them to change platforms. I don't care what platform they use. I care about results. I care about people getting results, getting more traffic to the website, making more money. So here's how we do that. You need to have some things in place, okay? What about optimized press? Yeah, Gal, I spoke about optimized press. See, again, optimized press is no different to Wix, Weebly, Squarespace. It's got a few more templates that you can use, and it's within WordPress, which makes it a little bit easier. But again, you're still limited to them. This is what I recommend. This is my recommendation. I've said about ClickFunnels, start there, then use WordPress. Now, I'm just going to check what time we're on, by the way, because I don't want to go too far over on this. 30 minutes. Right, I'll wrap this up in a minute. I'm going to make sure I go through this quickly. So if you've got a website, okay, one of the things that you need to understand is we want to get the customer from A to B. All right, and so this is so that they can purchase from you. And so what we need to do for them to purchase is we need to have a checkout. There needs to be a shopping cart. There are two main things that I recommend. One is called WooCommerce. WooCommerce is free. However, there is a cost involved in that. Another one is called Easy Digital Downloads. They are two systems. Now, you could use Shopify. You can use Magento. You can use loads of other systems. There's loads of other options for shopping carts. You can even use PayPal buttons. You know, there's lots of options out there. But the reality is, I'm not talking about any of them because Shopify is no different to Wix. All right? It's an e-commerce version of using Squarespace. You don't own it. You don't control it. It will get you out there and it will get you started, but you can't customize it. The reason I recommend WooCommerce is Easy Digital Downloads, the kind of the clues in the name, it's digital. So if you only have digital products, this is a great thing to use. If you're selling licenses or if you're selling sort of like themes, plugins or anything that needs a license key or anything, this is great for that. But what I use and what I recommend is WooCommerce. Now, the reason I said it's free, but that comes at a price, is because when you use WooCommerce, the base of the site works. You can create products, you can take payments, you can install Stripe and PayPal, which are payment gateways. I'll talk about that in a minute. So you can install those on WooCommerce for free. But anything else you want, if you want deposits, if you want subscriptions, if you want to group your products together, if you want a one-page checkout, then you have to pay. And because it is specialist, it's WordPress, and they make money out of it that way, they charge you. Like Woo subscriptions for a year's updates to Woo subscriptions, it's like $200. I think I pay close to $1,000 a year for my shopping cart on my website right now because of all the extensions that I've bought that go with it. However, if it's making you money in your business, then it's a cost. It's a business cost. And so you have to understand that. So many people go out there and go, oh no, I don't want to pay that. That's like $50 for a plugin. Like, I'm sorry, but if it helps make you money, then fucking pay it. And don't go looking for some gnarled, cracked, cheap plugin because you'll get a virus and your site won't work and you'll compromise your data and you'll look like a twat and your business won't survive. And I'm telling you that because I've done it and I learned the hard way because I used to use crack software. I used to go and find all the software I could, use it all, install it all. And then when I started doing client work, I realized I can't do that anymore because I want to be ethical, right? I want to be sustainable. And plus, I really want to support the people that are doing this because they're saving me the effort of coding it all. So, you know, you pay for it. Never paid anything for WooCommerce. Yeah, see, some people, you don't have to. If you can get away with using WooCommerce and using the WordPress.org is free. WooCommerce is free. You can pay £10 for a domain name. You can pay, you know, £10 a month for hosting. You can set everything up. You can pay $60. So you're paying like £100 and you can have a website running, taking payments. For £100, you can have a complete website that you own up and running. X-Theme, they've got one-click install, so you can click, you can install, set it up. Done. There's like YouTube channels and videos and everything, loads of stuff out there. I mean, I've got an entire course that teaches you this. But for £100, you can have a website up and running. Here's the thing. You still need to get them from A to B, all right? So let's go back a step. The customer journey. We talked about sales funnels. We've talked about marketing. We've talked about making money. The way you need to do that is get to people to opt in to your list. So one of the first things you're going to need to do is data capture, getting names and email addresses. And there's loads of ways that you can do this. And I'm not going to overwhelm you with all of the information. I'm just going to tell you from now on, I'm just going to tell you the one system that I use. Because there are so many different ways to do things. There are so many different ways. I don't want to overwhelm you with this. What I'm trying to tell you right now is if you use WordPress, all right, so this is WordPress, to capture details, I use what is called Gravity Forms. Okay, Gravity Forms. It is a phenomenal plugin for WordPress. Phenomenal. There's loads and loads of different options. Loads of different options. There's Typeform, Ninja Forms, this form, that form, every other kind of form. Gravity Forms is the only one you need. Use Gravity Forms. What you can do with Gravity Forms is if you've got a CRM system, like if you're using either Infusionsoft or ActiveCampaign or Entreport or anything like that for your CRM to build up your list. Because let me just let you know this, right? There's two things here, and this is really important. There's a CRM and there's an autoresponder, right? They're two different things. An autoresponder allows you to send out emails. An autoresponder allows you to send out emails to people who have registered. And so you can send out emails to them automatically. It automatically responds to them. Clues in the name. It's an autoresponder. For that, we have things like there's MailChimp. All right, that's probably the most popular one. There's AWeber, there's GetResponse, there's loads and loads of other options. But MailChimp is the main one that everyone knows, right? With MailChimp, the challenge is segmenting the list. And we talked about this in a different video. It's about having the different list segmentations. Go back and look at the one I talked about on autoresponders if you want to know more about that. So a CRM, the reason a CRM is different is because where this just sent, the autoresponder just sends out emails, the CRM, it builds up a picture. So it kind of builds up a picture of the person and it's like, okay, so this is Joe and Joe is this age and he works here and he does this and he has this. And so it builds up almost like a contact card. And then what you can do is most CRMs have an autoresponder built in. And so you build up a picture and then you email them based on their information. And you create specific emails based on their information. So if they do this, then we send them that. If they do that, then we send them this. And we basically create it like that. Okay. So depending on the CRM you use, you can plug Gravity Forms directly into your CRM. You can plug Gravity Forms directly into your CRM. So if in the future you change your CRM system, you've still got Gravity Forms. You don't have to change all of the forms that you've built. You don't have to rebuild your website. All you need to do is plug in a new CRM into Gravity Forms and it's done. What CRM providers? Now, I use Infusionsoft. I pay $200 a month for it and I've got a sweet deal with them. However, I am in the process of migrating over to ActiveCampaign at the moment and I, again, have a sweet deal with them too. The downside to ActiveCampaign is that they undercut Infusionsoft in the marketplace to make it cheaper to start. But as you scale, if I was to take the same package with ActiveCampaign as I have with Infusionsoft, I pay $200 a month for Infusionsoft, I would pay well over £1,200 for ActiveCampaign. Because that's where they get you when you scale. All CRM systems charge you based on two things: how many contacts you have and how many emails you send. And so if you do want to use ActiveCampaign, reach out to me. I don't get any commission for it, but I do have a really sweet deal with them. And I can get you a really, really good price for a good deal. So that's what I use anyway, personally. I'm using ActiveCampaign. Reason I'm using it, it's just better for what I need. I can visually move people through the system easier. I just prefer it. So what I then do is I have another plugin that I use. This is really important to me. It's called WP Fusion. You don't need this, but I have it and I recommend it. And the reason I recommend it is because this is the plugin that connects Gravity Forms up to your CRM. Because when you use a CRM, it basically, the CRM, all the CRM does is, it does lots of things, but it tags people. And what I mean by tagging people is it's like putting a post-it note onto someone's account. They bought this, they looked at that, they did this, and you build up a picture of them. Now, the great thing about using WP Fusion is I can tag people based on what page they view. I can tag people based on how long they're on a website. I can tag people based on any interaction they have with the website. And by doing that, I can build up a better picture in the CRM. So if someone visits my Plan Your Website page and someone visits my book page, but someone doesn't purchase my book, then I know that they viewed that page, but they didn't purchase it. And I can send them emails. I can even retarget them on Facebook saying, look, I know you looked at my book, but you didn't purchase it. You know, there's things that I can do. And if I notice that they looked at my book but they didn't purchase it and they've not contacted me for a couple of months, I could send them a discount coupon or I can even give them the book to get them started. There's things that I can do, there's processes. See, as a business owner, you should be more involved in the strategy of how to attract and how to convert your clients. You shouldn't be worried about all this. This is the tech stuff you don't need to worry about. However, you should still have an awareness of it. You should have an awareness of it so you know, so you can turn around to your developer and say, do you know what? I want you to go and set me up a WordPress website with Xtheme. I want you to install Gravity Forms, WooCommerce. Let's get a CRM system. I think we should use ActiveCampaign. Let's use WP Fusion. Okay, we're done. Systems are done. That's it. Don't mess about with anything else. That's all you need to get started. Now, there's some other things that you can use. There are some other things. I recommend you download a plugin on WordPress called Yoast. A great guy. Juice de Volk, he's a Dutch freaky deaky Dutch guy who runs a company called Yoast. Yoast is the leading authority in the world on SEO at the moment in terms of WordPress and SEO. Now, I'm not going to get too deep into this now because I'm aware I've gone over my time and I said I was only going to do 30 minutes with you. Too many people focus on SEO when they're starting out. I think you should use SEO best practice, and this teaches you best practice. This teaches you things to know about SEO. But don't consider that you're going to get all of your traffic through SEO. You're not going to build a website and all of a sudden rank top of Google and get loads of people coming to you. It's not going to happen. SEO is a 3 to 6 month and ongoing long game. Okay, it's something that is very, very powerful when you get there, but to get to the top spot in your industry, around all the competition, to get the keyword research, to get all of that stuff done, that is a minefield in itself, and it takes full teams, like full-time jobs, who are experts in this, to be able to SEO properly. So there are things that you can do. I highly recommend you SEO for your company name and your personal name. So if anyone Googles you or Googles your company, you come up. Like, in terms of SEO, I highly recommend you do that. But in terms of, like, competitive keywords and researching and that, yes, you should do it. But at the start, if you're getting started, you're much better in PPC, pay-per-click, and social media marketing. They're going to get you instant, quick results that will allow you an income that lets you invest in a team that can do the SEO for you, my opinion. Okay, reinvest your profits. Make money, reinvest it. Do it that way, my advice. But definitely get Yoast. Great plugin. So you've got Gravity Forms, you've got Yoast, you've got WooCommerce, you've got WordPress. All right, now we know for the autoresponders and CRMs, if you're using those, depending on what industry you're in, depending on what you're doing, if you have a podcast, then there's stuff you're going to need for your podcasting software. Okay, you're going to need SoundCloud, you're going to need Audello. There are other things you're going to need. You're going to need to look at things like Mixer. You're going to need to look at things like, you know, there's Lisbon. There's different things out there. If you're more of a visual person, let's say you're in the food industry, you're going to need to use things like Instagram. You're going to need to use things like Pinterest. All right, let's say you're in the events industry, you're going to need to use things like Foursquare. You're going to need things like Google Maps, you know. Depending on what you're doing, what industry you're in, there are going to be different requirements for you. But what I'm saying is that as a starting point, just to get you started on a system that will last you, I'm not giving you any advice on things that aren't going to last you for at least the next couple of years. I foresee this system working for at least the next 5 years. And there are people that are investing heavily in this. I know that websites have a shelf life. I know that apps are the way forward. And I know that app virtualization is something which will eventually kind of take over, just based on pure numbers of the mobile market. You know, how often do you scroll on a website on your phone anymore? Okay, we scroll, we use, like, the way that we consume information these days is like the way that we watch TV. We scroll. But rather than channel to channel, we scroll from app to app. So it's understandable that apps are taking over. And if you're sitting at a desktop, to have an app that you can blow up, like mobile first and blow it up onto a desktop and you can interact with that app, like you can get WhatsApp on your desktop, you can get Facebook Messenger on your desktop, you can get Facebook on your desktop, it's still a mobile app, right? So there's desktop versions, but I don't know if you're always going to need a website, which is kind of difficult for me because I wrote a book called Plan Your Website. And my whole business is called Plan, Build and Promote Your Website. So I'm just being honest, right? I could bullshit you into, yeah, like, you know, buy into this, it's going to last forever. It's not. Here's another thing. I'm just going to leave you on this nugget. I watched a clip from Gary Vee last night, and it was something that he said, and this fascinated me. I thought this was absolutely phenomenal. So it was a Gary Vee clip, credits to him for this, but he basically said, all of the massive big companies out there at the moment, Pepsi, Coca-Cola, everyone like that, all of the huge big players, like the Super Bowl that happened recently, like you consider how much money was spent on creating that advert and paying for that 30 seconds. You know, when you're looking at like Land Rover or whoever it was, I didn't watch the Super Bowl, so I don't know, but when you consider how much money was invested to create that ad and it doesn't work. It doesn't really work. There's a big thing around it. But if they were to take that money, they spent something like 80 million, or it was something insane. Imagine having an 80 million budget to put into Facebook ads. Imagine what that would do to Facebook. So my point is this. We are at right now, and this is the point Gary made, and I've made it before myself, and it's really important. Right now, today, right now, you have the best opportunity you will ever have to promote your business. The best opportunity. Because once these giants, once these corporate mammoths get into this, what all the entrepreneurs and internet marketers and people are doing, once they realize that they're not making the money through the Super Bowl ad and they take that budget and they throw it into Facebook ads, you're fucked. There's nothing you're going to be able to do to compete because they have these insane budgets. So now, whilst it's cheap, whilst you have the ability to get in and to use this, it makes absolute perfect sense to not focus on this. This doesn't matter. The only purpose of this is to get your customer from their problem to their solution. And if you can create a system that takes you out of the process so that you don't have to be involved. Here's another example. Do you book appointments? Do you have people that have to schedule time with you? Because if you do, and you can see this on my website, I practice what I preach. If you're using WooCommerce as an example, and again, there's lots of different options. You can have an option where you say, contact me, email me, or send me a contact, or if you want to book a call, you know, click this link. Here's the reality. I would much rather ask a series of questions to pre-frame somebody, and then I would get them to book a call. Here's my calendar, book, and it will book a time, and it will go straight into Google Calendar. Because if it ain't in Google Calendar, it ain't happening. It's as simple as that. If it is not in Google Calendar for me, it doesn't happen. So, having a system where they can go on your website, answer some questions, book a time with you, it automatically checks your calendar, finds out when you're free, lets them know, tells them they can book it, done. You do not have to be involved in that entire process. Now they've booked a call with you, either a 20-minute discovery, or they've paid for an hour consultation, or whatever it may be. You don't have to pre-frame them with questions. I just prefer to do that, see, because you don't want to waste your time with free calls, right? You don't want people booking your time and then wasting time with them if they're not ever going to be interested for you. That's why I do these Facebook Lives. It's because I want to give value and I'm happy to do this. And everyone can watch it in their own time and you can do your own thing with it and you can use it. But once I'm done with this, I'm done. I can repurpose it. I can use it. But if I'm sitting here and individually I go through with each and every one of you for 20 minutes at a time, it's going to eat into my day. So you need to look at the systems you can build. So if you have this, there's one called WP Appointments. Now, that's what I personally use, WP Appointments. I use it because it links into WooCommerce. My website has a shopping cart, WooCommerce. WooCommerce is my hub. Everything happens around WooCommerce. People come to my website, they purchase, it goes into WooCommerce. From WooCommerce, it goes to Xero. Xero is my bookkeeping software that I use. I have a plugin from Xero, and so when people purchase from me, it automatically sends an invoice to them, and it sends the bookkeeping software to Xero. So I don't have to reconcile my accounts, it's done automatically. Also, if they book an appointment, it's sent to Google Calendar, it's done automatically. I don't have to be involved. Can these be entered in iCal? Yeah, you can choose between Google Calendar or iCal. It normally gives you a link. If you don't want to use WP Appointments, an easier and a monthly option, there's Calendly. Calendly is a great one. Or what I really like is Acuity. Acuity Scheduling. Fantastic system. There's a monthly fee to it. But the reason I don't use Acuity Scheduling is because it doesn't hook into WooCommerce. And everything that I use and everything I do hooks into WooCommerce. Hopefully this has helped. Look, there's a lot of information here, and I get that. My point is, and I want to make this really clear, simple things. WordPress website, WooCommerce as a checkout, Gravity Forms to collect data and information, X theme to be able to build everything out, get yourself an autoresponder, either MailChimp or if you can afford it, ActiveCampaign, link them up, build the systems. Focus on the journey. Focus on creating the content. Focus on solving the problem. Focus on sending people from their problem to their solution. Your website should be agile. You should be able to create new offers, create new products, create new systems, create new services. It should be easy for you to be able to do that. And that's why ClickFunnels is so successful, because it allows you to quickly and easily create that. Anthony, thanks, mate. I appreciate it. I'm just going to go through all the questions really quickly now before I head off. I know I went a little bit over with this one. It was a big subject. I'm really sorry. I said 30 minutes. It's more like an hour. I'm just going to look through the questions quickly. But guys, thank you so much. If you think this is valuable, If what I've said to you is valuable, can you please just tag someone that you think would like to hear it? Like this, like send me some love, send me some hearts, share it if you think that someone should know about it. And also, just so that you know, I'm going to be doing a webinar on Thursday, 14th, Valentine's Day. I'm going to do it in the afternoon. So I will be putting a page up today. I will be sharing a link on my Facebook with the page where you can register. I'm going to be doing a webinar, and on that webinar, I'm going to go through everything. I'm going to give you absolutely everything you need to know. And the main thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take away the overwhelm. I'm going to make it super, super simple so you don't... Like, I'm trying to cram as much as I can in here, but I'm really trying to do it in a way that I give you the value, but I don't overwhelm you. And I know it's difficult because there's so many people in so many different industries. Whilst I'm trying to give you an awareness of everything, the outcome is to remember simple. One system, one process, one outcome, focus on that, get that working, and then use the money that you make from that to reinvest in other things. All right, you don't need a developer anymore. You may need a designer, but you don't even need a designer to build out your entire brand. All you need are some digital assets, a few things that look good, a color palette, the typography you're going to use, your logo, and a few digital assets. Create that. You've got everything that you need to market yourself. That's all you need. And then it's just a case of you going out there and delivering the value, knowing your customer audience, knowing how to communicate with them, and building out the system. That's all it is. Systems should not be complicated. People spend far too much time on websites these days. So I'm just looking through some of these comments. Gal, hello. Robert, hello. Robert, hello. Kel, hello. Talk about new themes. Have you seen Arc theme? It's been launched in December. I haven't, and I won't. And the reason I won't is because now I don't look at, like, there are new things that are coming out and I'm sure they're great. What I tend to do now, my personal opinion, is when anything's launched, there's an initial period of hype. And so everything will go through its initial period of hype of, oh, check this out, this is amazing, this is the next best thing. Sort of 6 months after it's launched, that hype will have died down and you'll start to understand that all of the beta testers and all, because if you go into something that's just been launched, there's going to be problems. Like, we have it with Apple. Like, how often do Apple release a new phone and we get it and then we have to fix all their problems for them? Do you know what I mean? It's like, there's always going to be, like, a beta testing stage. And so, for me, I'd rather, like, I'm happy to go through and test stuff, but I'm not going to look or spend my time right now investing in things like that. Not right now. For me, I'll let the hype go, I'll let that initial period go, and then 6 months in, I'll look at the support side of things. How were the developers and how were the core contributors, how are they reacting and dealing with problems? And are they overcoming them? And if they are, and they're active and they're working on it, and it's worth looking at, then I'll start playing with it. I tend to do that now, unless it's something that is recommended by a trusted source, or something that I really want to know about. There's so many things out there. There's so many themes. There's so many plugins. You can get so distracted. I'm not about getting distracted anymore. I'm about, like, let's just get done what we need to do. All right. The only thing that we should be focused on right now is results. Hey, Pete. Hey, Stephanie. Hey, Kofi. WordPress user. What systems do you use? Let me know. What's your website built on right now? Is it Squarespace? Is it Wix? Is it Weebly? Is it WordPress? I'm curious. Is it ClickFunnels? I'm just curious what you're using. What I really admire about you is your honesty. Thank you. I appreciate that. I did my best. Loving your raw, real honesty. So refreshing. I can't remember what I said now, but thank you. after so much missing information and rip-off developers, it's true. Like, you know, but here's the thing, right? Everyone's doing the best they can. I'm not sitting here trying to badmouth anyone. I'm not sitting here trying to put anyone else down to put myself up. What I'm saying is that I've either been through this process myself or I've done this myself. You know, I've let people down in the past. I've built websites that haven't worked in the past. You know, I've made mistakes. I've struggled with marketing. Many of you will know that, like, a little while ago, you know, I was coming across as desperate, trying to push myself out there, trying to bring clients in. The reality is that people can smell that a mile off. It doesn't work. Like, I need to just stay in my flow. Like, I'm moving this weekend out of my house. I've got all of this stuff going on at the moment. My whole life is absolutely chaotic. And yet I am focused on delivering these midday mastery sessions. I am focused on delivering my podcasts. I am focused on delivering with my clients. You know, I've got a site that's about to go live, which is going to be amazing. When you see it, I'm telling you now, once this site goes live in a couple of weeks, and we push this out there, and I'm like, look what we've just built, I'm going to have an influx of people wanting to work with me. Because it happens all the time. It happened with Global Angels. It's happened with all of the sites that I've built for people. All right, so I know that when these, and in fact, there's 3 sites right now that are about to go live. They're in the process. When they, all 3 of them go live, I'm going to have so many people come to me saying, I want a website, I want a website. Because they're going to see it, they're going to see the results, and they're going to say, I want that. And so what I've been doing is trying to get those people now without showing off that work because it's still being built. And, you know, respectfully for the clients, I'm not going to show that information just yet. I'm going to wait because it's the client. The client should have the right to show that off, not me. I'm not the person who says, look what I've built. That's for the client to say, look what we've created. It's theirs. It's not mine. That's not my trophy to hold up. That's not my thing. But when it happens, I know I'll get business out of it. So right now, my whole life is crazy, but I've got this certainty around my business. It's the only thing I know right now I can control because I know I'm fucking good at it. I know all of this makes sense. And I know because I've done this. I've used every system out there. I've spent so much time and I've struggled because of it. And right now I know that there is one simple process. And if you follow that one simple process and just do that one simple thing, you will get results. That's it. You just need to go from A to B and you need to do it in the quickest and easiest way possible. Let's look through some of these questions. Simon, I learned from him a lot online marketing. Yeah, Simon's great at online marketing. But see, that's the thing. He's an online marketer. When you look at what Simon does in the world of online marketing, he's not a website developer. He doesn't know how to build websites. He knows how to leverage people. And that's what he does. He leverages people in India, the Philippines, places like that. Outsources. Cost is effective. It's cheap. Here's a problem. Here's a real problem with using people in India and the Philippines. They understand how to put sites together and how to do things. They don't understand business. They don't understand business. And I mean that with greatest respect. So what I'm working on at the moment, a part of my, like, I'm doing an accreditation system where I'm going to be certifying people to show that they are, like, they are online masters. Okay, and so for these online masters, for them to go through the accreditation and for them to get certified with me, they're going to have to go through a process. They're going to have to show competence above and beyond in their field, right? And there's four fields. And they're also, as well as being a master in their own field, they are going to need to be able to show that they have an understanding in the other three fields. Okay, so they're going to be designers. I'm going to have certified designers, and the designers are going to have to know about responsive design, mobile first design. They're going to have to understand the difference between brand, you know, the typography, all the different things that make the branding of a business. Because as well as knowing design, as well as understanding design, they need to understand the business, they need to understand the developers, and they need to understand marketing. They have to have an awareness of the other three areas. There's going to be developers. The developers, from the functionality point of view, are going to need to be able to talk to the designers. Because designers and developers, they don't communicate very well with each other. One's left side of the brain, one's right side of the brain. They think completely differently. So to bring them together normally ends up like that, and they end up fighting each other and rubbing off. That's where a lot of conflict comes from. So what I'm going to do is make sure that they're educated, that they understand each other and come from a central place. The third type of person is the business owner. So a designer is going to need to understand a developer and also understand a business. They need to understand the outcome is to make money and to take the customer from A to B. And how can you create a story that takes them from A to B to visually guide them through an emotional journey that takes them from their pain to their solution? These are things they're going to have to consider. And fourth and finally is going to be marketing. Okay, you need to be able to market and project and promote yourself. And so a designer, developer, marketer and business owner, they are the four cornerstones of what I'm building. And so that will be the basis of my accreditation and my certification that I'm doing. And everything that I'm showing and teaching and everything that I'm doing is based around those principles. Because in the last 4 or 5 years, everything that I've learned in business, in personal development, in branding, in marketing, in design, in development, everything I've learned, I'm giving to you now. I'm just giving it to you. There's the option, if you want, for me to work with you. I'm more than happy to work with you and to do this for your business. Because when you get me in your business to do this for you, it is like a rocket up your ass. I'm telling you now, you will get profits. If you don't get profits, you don't pay me. It's as simple as that. But I can't make it any easier. All right? I do one thing. One thing. I have one focus. I have a 6-week course. Starts on the 1st of March. 6-week course. I come into your business. We do everything. We plan everything out from start, wherever you are, start to finish. You're not making money, you don't pay me. It's as simple as that. If you're interested, just type below. Put interested and I'll let you know about it. I'm actually only taking on a few more people. Now, I sent out an email the other day. Said I was looking for 15 more people. I don't know how many people I'm looking for now. I need to check the numbers. But I can tell you right now, I am not taking that many more. I'm not taking on as many people as I initially wanted. I had this grand idea that, and I mentioned this yesterday, for my ego, I wanted to do a 6-figure launch. It also would have cleared a lot of the backlog through my divorce and everything that's going on at the moment. So I was really, really keen that I wanted to do that and just to prove to myself and to everyone else. But do you know what? If I did a 6-figure launch right now, all I am doing is positioning myself with the people like Ty Lopez. Ah, look at me, I've made loads of money and you should copy me because I've made loads of money. And I just look like a dick. What I'd rather do is take sort of a smaller group of 20 people, get 20 people on board, work really, really hard with those 20 people to get their massive results and use their results to push in the next course. So, as I said, I've already got 10 people. I think I've probably got a few more than that right now. If you want me to work with you 1st of March, you're more than welcome to. It's 6 weeks. You get everything I've ever made digitally, plus you get me personally for 6 weeks on your business. Been working on mine almost every other day, tweaking it over 2 years, always tweaking it, never ending. I'd like your consultation on it, Steve. Kofi, mate, send me a message. Let's have a chat. Gal, have you heard of PageCloud? If so, what do you think of it? Yes, I have heard of PageCloud, but again, it's something else that I'm not going to push into at the moment for the reasons I mentioned. PageCloud for me is, it's another distraction right now. There's a load of systems and there's a lot of marketers out there that are spinning things from a different angle. Like, oh, this is the next best thing, or oh, this is the next new thing, or oh, this does that, or this does this. That you don't need it. You don't need it. Don't need anything new. Don't need anything shiny. You just need what I've showed you. Use that. It works. Ryan, thank you very much, mate. Agile, I feel like I don't do this. Rhett, absolutely you don't do this. But Rhett, do you know the reason you don't do this? Because you've got so much content. You're like a big woolly mammoth. When you look at your website, it's huge. It's like an elephant. It's massive. And so it's slow and it takes time. However, like the T-Rex and the Velociraptor, you have the ability to move between the two. You can set up little bits of your website that are agile and you have your whole system in the back end, which is like the tank that drives it. But you can still go out there and you can still do things and you just need some tweaks. Like we've spoken about this before, mate, and I know that with some small tweaks you can streamline. Your biggest challenge in your business at the moment is not about being agile, it's not about all of this. Your biggest challenge right now is your customer journey, is making sure that your customers understand what it is you do and how it helps them. Because right now you've put you have so much knowledge in your head. You are so good at what you do that you've just gone poof, and put it all online. And right now it's just there. And what you now need to do is you need to, like, if you're going to make a cake, you know, you need to roll out the dough, you need to make sure it's nice, you need to put it into its shape, you need to build it up. That's what you need to do now. You know, you need to present it in a way that it looks edible, that people want it. Because right now it's just a big lump of dough, which is all very good and it's nice, but it you need to now put the icing on it. That's all you need to do, mate. Hey, Debbie. Hey, everyone. Hi, guys. I'm on Freelancer. Dylan, yeah. Do you know what? I was for a long time. In fact, I wrote about it in my book. I was on Elance. I was on People Per Hour. I was on all of these sites. I was whoring out my services for next to nothing, trying to compete with people. Living in London, I couldn't afford to compete with the people in India and the Philippines to build websites, which is why I actually started asking the question, what can I do differently? What can I do that is different to everybody else? And I come up with the answer, it was strategy. Because most of the people that are building websites don't actually have a clue why they're building it. Biggest problem you have when you say, I need a website, is going to someone who doesn't know what questions to ask you. You go to somebody and say, I need a website, and they're like, okay, build your website. There's your website. And what? There's no structure, there's no plan, there's no strategy behind it. Why do you need a website? What's the purpose? What's the outcome? Like, people don't ask those questions. They just build your website because you asked for it, so they give it to you. That's not their fault. They're doing what you asked. And it's not your fault because you don't know what questions to ask. But you're the one who's left with the problem at the end of the day. You're the one who's left with a website that doesn't work. Which is why so many people are not using developers anymore. They're using Wix and Squarespace and Weebly because they're scared. They're scared because, look, if I told you that I could make you £1,000 a month and you had to invest £100, it's a no-brainer. If you knew that you could get a return, you'd do it. People don't know they can get a return. They're scared. There's so much tripe and crap out there. They see so many other people struggling. They don't want to invest because they're worried about it. So all I'm trying to say is, like, before you go mental and throw all that stuff out there, take a step back, look at what you need, get ClickFunnels, test it, get a simple system, make it work. Once it works, once you see profits, reinvest it. You don't need to build the whole ship. Fiverr.com is a joke.com. Do you know what? Fiverr.com's really good for some things. Like, for example, if you went onto Video Hive and you bought a video template that you wanted for an intro and you give them your logo and you said, here's my logo, here's this thing, put my logo in here, do that. And you went on and found someone that's got, like, if you don't have Photoshop or if you don't have Adobe Illustrator or if you don't have it, like that, little jobs like that, great. You know, fantastic. Do this, do that, do these little things. Don't buy likes. Don't get people to do complicated work. Don't get people to do stuff that Yeah, like, it's $5, they only get paid $4. Someone who gets paid $4 an hour, I don't care where they live in the world, they're not that good, because if they were, they'd value themselves more. All right, and I don't care if you say that there's upsells and they could charge $50 or $100. Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm Online Mastery, brilliant, I listen, thanks, I appreciate it. Where can we tune into the podcast? So I'm just about to upload everything, I'm tweaking it, I'm looking for some feedback. In fact, if you look back through my profile right now, I posted it on SoundCloud. If you got SoundCloud, Online Mastery, or if you just have a look at my profile, I posted the first episode. I would really, really appreciate if you can just listen and just scroll past it. Just like skip, listen to the intro, skip through a few bits. Just give me some feedback. Because whatever feedback you give me, I will use that to adapt the template that I'm going to use for my future podcasts. All right, I'm using things like Smart Passive Income, Pat Flynn, things like that. You know, I'm using a lot of other people that are doing podcasts and have done podcasts. But yeah, I really like the idea of, I'm using Audello, that's what I'm going to push and pump everything out to. Huge, huge shout out to Adil for hooking me up with that and sorting me out. Amazing guy, Adil Marcy, if you don't know him, connect with him. Fantastic copywriter. He has hooked me up with that. I only use X Theme 2, India, look at you guys, look at everyone on X. All of this is my life story. Oh man, look, Kofi, we need to have a chat, brother. Dandy C. Cullen, lots of interesting info here regarding our website. Ryan, thanks for sharing, man. Appreciate it. I come to you because I knew you were my... because I knew you knew my theme. That's it, man. Great idea. Cornerstone, fantastic. What about Optimized Press? Gone through that. The website is already HTML coded. Do you suggest an SEO developer? Do I suggest an SEO developer? So I'm just going to touch on that for a second. Let me just have a look, because I think I've gone well over an hour now. Sorry. This 30 minutes, right? Is this all right, though? Shall I keep going, or shall I stop this? Like, give me some thumbs up if you want me to keep going, because I'm kind of zoned out right now and just delivering, like, what I believe to be value for you guys. So if you find this valuable, let me know, and I'll keep going. Otherwise, I'm more than happy just to cut this, because I'm well aware that I've gone over what I promised. All right, guys. I'll carry on. So, if the website is already HTML coded, do you suggest an SEO developer? It's a really interesting question, because SEO developer, it's that language. There's not an SEO developer. There's somebody who understands SEO, right? And you can implement SEO into anything. So, if your website has been coded in HTML, which is basically just the coding language, even WordPress works on HTML. So HTML is like the base language that they use, and then PHP is another version above that. So you have your HTML and your PHP, which is your coding languages, and then you have some additional things as well. Like, one's called CSS, which is all about the styling and how it looks, and one is called JavaScript, which is all about making it like flashy and doing like, you know, awesome things. There's more detail involved in it, but that's the basics. Like, HTML and PHP is your core, and then JavaScript and CSS, like, you need CSS, because it makes it look and feel the way it does. But in terms of SEO, that's a completely different thing. Like, there are some things, like some good practices in SEO, like the template hierarchy, as in like the markup of the page, where to use header 1, header 2, header 3, what's a sidebar, what's main content area. You know, there are things that you use in terms of the structure and layout of the HTML to SEO the page. And any developer should understand and use that as good practice. Any developer. So in terms of SEO, SEO really starts, like the absolute starting point of SEO is keyword research. You have to start with keyword research. Doesn't matter what else you do, because like there is no point SEOing your website for the keyword dinosaur if you have absolutely nothing to do with dinosaurs. It's pointless. All right, so you need to understand who your target market is. You need to understand who your customer avatar is. I keep coming back to this. Once you know who your customer avatar is, once you know what their problem is, once you know what their pain is, once you know how to communicate and identify with them, then you can weave the words that relate to them into your keyword research. You can think, okay, so let's just say, for example, panic attacks, right? I'm going to use panic attacks as example. Let's say... I'm winging this. I'm just going to say, let's imagine you're a hypnotherapist and your speciality is you help people overcome panic attacks. All right, just use this for, just play with me for this. Just imagine what I'm going through. In terms of, you're a hypnotherapist, You focus on people overcoming panic attacks. So when you start to get into the mind of the person, someone's having a panic attack, someone's stressed out, someone's not thinking straight, let's just imagine that they're sick and tired, they're had enough, they don't want panic attacks anymore, they go on to Google, what do they type in? How do I stop having panic attacks? How to stop panic attacks? They're the sort of things that will be typed in. So those are what you'll use in your keywords. Okay, and when your keyword research, you'll start to think from the customer's perspective, or from the prospect, from their perspective, what are the things that they're going to say? What are the things that they are going to put out there? And when you do that, then you start to figure out the keywords. Then you start to use those keywords in the content, which is how you SEO. And there's other things to do as well. When you do your keyword research, you need to look at competitors. What are they doing? What's a high competitive keyword? What's a low competitive keyword? The elixir of SEO, the absolute what you're looking for, is to find a keyword that loads and loads of people are searching for that not many people are competing against. And then you optimize all your content for that and off you go. But as I said, to start with, the main thing you want is your name. Whatever your name is, whatever your business name is, you want to make sure you're SEOing for those. There's loads of different things about SEO. SEO is one aspect, like the keyword research is one aspect. Another aspect of it is optimizing your content. Another aspect is what's called backlinks. So linking out and getting somebody on another website to link to your content. Because that in Google, like you've got to imagine, Google is it's a spider's web, the World Wide Web, right? If you come right back to the beginning and imagine a web, it's made up of loads of little strands. Right, and that's all this is. It's loads of little strands. And so the more connected you are, the stronger your web is. Now, Google will not look for your website. All Google does is it sends out its little spiders, or its bots, as they're called, and it goes out, its little code, goes out into the internet, and it goes from link to link to link to link to link, and it just gathers all the information. And that's all it does. The only way that a spider can progress from one place to the next is via a link that connects it on the web. It's the little strand on the web. And so the more strands that you have coming into your website, the stronger your web is, the more chance a bot is going to find you. Alternatively, you can tell Google you exist. You can use what's called a sitemap and you can upload that to Google. In fact, I'm going to do a whole thing around SEO. Let's not get into it now. I could go so deep in this and I don't want to get too carried away. I'll do a whole Midday Mastery on SEO and we'll talk about that. But for now, good practice, you need that, but like, don't get too overwhelmed with it. Right now, the main thing that you need to consider is who are you targeting, where are they, and what's the most cost-effective way for you to get them from A to B to make money so you can reinvest it. That's it. That should be the outcome. Does Shopify work on WordPress.org? No, Shopify is completely different. Shopify is Shopify, WordPress is WordPress. So Shopify is, it's a bit like saying, does WordPress and Wix work together? So Shopify is just like Squarespace or Wix or Weebly. It's just an e-commerce solution for it. And Shopify is great. And as I said, like the same way as Squarespace is great, Shopify is great. But you don't own your shopping cart. You're renting it on a space where you're paying a monthly fee and you're limited in what you can do. See, for me, I want custom cut checkout pages with one-time offer upsells, and I want to be able to add in things depending on what people have done. So depending on what people have purchased in the past, depends on what they purchase in the future. It's all about the customer journey for me, and I can only customize that customer journey when I have control, which is why I need to use WordPress. I'm not saying that you should use it, but I'm just saying that, you know, Shopify is great to get started, but I highly recommend WooCommerce. Okay, I've heard of Infusionsoft comes with a huge learning curve. Yeah, it's called Confusionsoft. Infusionsoft does come with a huge learning curve. Here's the thing though, everything has a learning curve. It just depends, like, you know, if it was easy, everyone would be doing it, right? If this was easy, everyone would be out there building websites, making money. The reason so many people struggle is because it's not that easy. And the reason it's not that easy is because we get distracted. Infusionsoft is really, really simple if you put one day aside and you go through it step by step and you just set up what you need to set up. Active campaign's easier, okay? Active campaign's probably the best one, but Infusionsoft's got loads of training. There's loads of stuff out there. You just need to make sure that you're getting the advice from the right people. I spend a day with you on Infusionsoft and you're set up and sorted. It's done. So it depends on who you speak to. And there's some amazing people that can help you with it. But the problem is, there's just too much information out there. Mind blown, thank you very much. So much value. Awesome. Thanks, guys. Look, if you're getting value from this, please tag me. Like, I would love it if you could just share this and just write something nice about me. I'm not going to beg for the attention, but I would be grateful for it. Because what I'll do is screenshot that and I'll use that on my website somewhere to say, hey, look what this amazing person said about me. I'm just being honest. It's what I do. It's my testimonials that I use. I think I've done all you've mentioned, Steve. I'll have to speak to you about conversion. No worries. Would a webinar be recorded? I'd like to see it, but I'm going out with my wife on Tuesday. Do you know what? That is a good answer. And the reason I'm doing it earlier is because it is Valentine's Day and I'm well aware of that. Yes, it will be recorded. As well as it being recorded, I will be rerunning it a week later. Not the recording version, I will be doing another live webinar. I am going to be doing a live webinar on the 14th, on the 21st and on the 28th. I'm going to do 3 live webinars. And I'm going to take the best one of those and I'm going to automate it and it will become evergreen. And I will talk to you all about that another time. I missed the first 15 minutes. We'll have to catch up as soon as possible. No worries, Dylan. I understand you about the Arc theme. He's doing Dreamweaver, One.com. I'm going to use the free info and turn it into a killer customer journey. Yeah, you absolutely should, mate. Anthony, let's have a chat, mate. March, I'm clearing a diary. All right, let's have a chat, brother. Tweak me. I thought I said twerk. Someone said that yesterday. Rhett introduced me to you. Dylan, nice to meet you, man. Thank you. Yeah, Rhett's a great guy. I have a Wix site, but I'm grading it now. Dylan, we should have a chat, man. I can definitely give you some advice. Beju, hello. How you doing, brother? Keep going. Megan, hello. Right, okay, guys. So I've gone absolutely well over and below of what I said I was going to do. I'm sorry if, obviously, you know, this has gone on so long, but hopefully it's been useful. Thank you ever so much. I'm really, really grateful. Thank you for your time, for sitting through this. I hope it's been useful for you. I will be doing another one tomorrow. Tomorrow's Midday Mastery Friday. I'm actually going to be talking about hosting. I'm going to be talking about hosting, why hosting is important, things to consider with hosting, and things that you probably didn't consider. Some things that you may need to know. You'll be able to catch all of these on YouTube. So if you pop over to Online Mastery... If you pop over to Online Mastery UK... on YouTube, just type in Online Mastery into YouTube, subscribe to me. There's a Midday Mastery. I'm uploading all of these Facebook Lives onto YouTube so you can see them all there. Have an amazing day and I'll speak to you all soon. Take care. Bye-bye.